dessert to your Thanksgiving feast. Rattler fans, we are now in our grand finale of the St. Mary's Classic 2013. It'll pit St. Mary's versus Emporia State. Welcome inside Mill Green here. And David Tomar bringing you the call here. I'd like to be joined momentarily by one Chad Peters. Of course, that man is always on the go, as are the Rattlers. Rattlers are coming off a thriller in the opening game of the St. Mary's Classic. They defeated Central Missouri 81-78 in overtime last night. Fast forward 24 hours, and they are right back at it once again. Let's meet the starting five for your St. Mary's Rattlers. It'll be the same five as yesterday's game. Monroe, Thomas, Bolton, Witt, and Bauer. And of course, Witt, a career high 21 points as a Rattler. 14 of 14 from the free throw line. Clutch free throws down the stretch. It was really the story. Talking to the coaching staff before this game, they were really proud of how Witt stepped up for his team and really led his team on the court and really led the charge in that overtime. As the story of the game, 57 fouls called in the game yesterday. Four Rattlers fouling out, three of Central Missouri's players fouling out. The Rattlers literally down to one guy on the bench. It was Anthony, the only guy on the bench. Rattlers had a roll with Bauer, Witt, Bolton, AK, and Smith on that in the overtime. So it was one of those lineups that you really don't see. And of course, the Rattlers putting out the win, and they're looking to continue that trend here. 2-0 lead early on here for Emporia State. Starting for them, Caleb Wright, Gavin Brown, Terrence Moore, Makai Swank, and Paul Bunch. Five in the Emporia State black. Here's Bolton driving, puts it up. Tough shot, no good. Offensive board, Monroe trying to wrestle for it, and he does. It'll be a jump ball, and the Rattlers will keep possession here. Emporia State getting two free throws here to go, and they lead it early on 2-0. That shot is launched, no good by Witt. Of course, we talked about 21 points. There's Witt again, trying to get the steal, and he is held back there by number 11, Terrence Moore. So that foul will go against Moore. That'd be a pass interference in football. Here he is called for a foul, so possession swings right back to St. Mary's. About a minute down, St. Mary's still looking for the first points of the game. Here's Monroe, top of the key, looking, swings around. Bauer left side. And an offensive foul here. It goes against Bolton. That'll be his first second team foul for St. Mary's here. And you kind of have to wonder, is there going to be a little bit of a hangover, a little bit of the wear and tear? Is that going to show here early on in this game? And the Rattlers there force a turnover, and they'll get possession right back. I mean, keep in mind, these Rattlers played in an overtime game just 24 hours ago. Marvin Witt, he played all 45 minutes of yesterday's ballgame. So you have to keep an eye out on not only him, but the rest of these Rattlers. Here's Monroe backing down, turn, spin, shoots. That's good. And Monroe grabs the first points of the game for St. Mary's. All even at two. This three is launched. No good by Caleb Wright. Rebound out to Moore. Moore not able to put that in. And the Rattlers finally secure the rebound. Bauer almost stepping out of bounds. Skinning the cat there. Now Witt loses it. Emporia State in transition. The Hornets, that's good. Makai Swank able to control the possession. Contort in midair and get that layup to go. 2-4 the score. Rattlers here trying to get something going. Emporia State, a very good team there. 6-2 on their season. They're 1-1 away from home. Here is Witt for three. That one almost, but no good. Offensive board by Thomas, not able to put that in. Here comes Wright. Met by Bolton, gets right past two Rattlers in gold and not able to finish off that layup. Now Bauer and Thomas gain possession for St. Mary's. That one goes behind the back of Bauer. Now Bolton, right side, looking, finding Monroe. That one's poked away by Gavin Brown. And they'll say possession was last touched by St. Mary's. A little bit about Emporia State. They are the Hornets. They're 6-2 on the year, 1-1 away from home. They won their first game of the Thanksgiving Classic over Southeastern Oklahoma State, 81-66. Their leading scorer is Caleb Wright at 15.1 points per game, and their leading rebounder is number 10, Jay Temmett, off the bench, right around 7 boards a game. They also have a lot of good scorers. Number 11, Terrence Moore, averages about 14 a game, and number 32, Paul Bunch, averages just a bit over 10 points per game. Those are their leading scorers. Here is Emporia State. It's a swank down low. That is good for Bunch. Count it and the foul. So the score is 6-2. It was already up there. Rattlers already with 14 fouls. And Joe Monroe already in foul trouble. So Alexander will join Thomas, Witt, Bolton, and Bauer. Here's the first free throw, and that is good. Bunch completes the three-point play. 7-2 the score, a five-point deficit for St. Mary's. Now some press being played here by Emporia State. Here's Bolton. He turns it over. And just like that, Emporia State gives it right back. So the Rattlers build out there. But you got to feel the pressure yourself if you're a Rattler fan with that press coming and the pressure being shown by Emporia State. Here comes Bolton again. Now to Alexander. Bolton. Nice up fake. Finds Witt. Witt against the big man. He takes it right to him. Marvin Witt, fearless, takes it up. Marvin Witt, 5'9". He takes it right up on the 6'11". Paul Bunch gets the layup to go. And just like that, the Rattlers are down three. Could be the shot in the arm they needed. And an offensive foul adding to that shot in the arm for St. Mary's. What a play there by Witt. And we saw him. It was a coming out party for him as a St. Mary's Rattler. Really getting used to his role of six man. In this game and the one yesterday, he is a starter and, well, proven that he can play any role on this team. He is a delightful scorer. There he comes again. That's high off the glass, and there is Alexander to finish that off. Gets that tip in to go. 6-7 the score now, and the Rattlers right back in business, down one. Right under 16 minutes remaining here in the first half. Emporia State trying to regain their composure. Nice ball movement. Better defense by the Rattlers so far. Driving in. That shot no good. Rebounded by Bunch. And he is knocked down to the floor. He will go to the line following this media timeout. Rattler fans, make sure to stay with us. More upcoming. The grand finale to the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic. Right here on Rattler Network.
If you drive buzzed, it could cost you around $10,000. You'll face major legal fees, major fines, and steep insurance penalties. You could lose everything. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. 15:36 remaining in the first half. We got a tight one early on, 6-7 the score. This is the grand finale of the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic 2013, my fourth time covering a Thanksgiving Classic. Always fun and always a good way to ease yourself out of the food coma that, of course, Thanksgiving can bring, and it's a good way to relax after the Black Friday. Of course, a special hello to everyone watching, all our viewers, wherever you may be. Thank you for watching. Hopefully, you had a terrific Thanksgiving. I know this broadcaster sure did. His Cowboys won. Got to spend time with my family. It was always a good time. And, of course, got to spend the rest of the weekend with my Rattler family, as that first free throw is no good for Paul Bunch. And of course, a special hello to our Rattler Network colleagues at home enjoying their time with their families. Joe Rodriguez over in Dallas, Texas, and Brian McGluion over in Houston. And, of course, our Rattler Network alum over in Bristol, Connecticut, at the four letters, Rawls Tovar, hello. Watching this one intently. 6-8 the score here as the St. Mary's Rattlers trailed by as many as five. They've cut it down to one. Now it's at two. Bauer, Witt, Wilson now on the floor for St. Mary's. Alexander and Thomas at the top. Bauer looking to make a play happen. Gets a screen from Thomas. Bauer driving. Picks up his dribble. Over to Alexander. Back to Bauer. Thomas trying to get some position down low. Shot clock at five. Bauer. I don't know if he tried to put that up, but it was deflected. Here's Thomas. Tough shot, and he got that to go. Thomas, good bucket there. 8-8 is the score. Here is Swank over to Wright. Wright dribbling. He is stripped. Here's Witt. Not going to be able to catch him, and gets another layup to go. Marvin Witt already picking up right where he left off last night. 4 points for him already. He had 21 in last night's overtime affair. And Terrence Moore trying to keep up with him from Emporia State. You're not going to catch him. Good dish right there by Emporia State. And the shot is made by Paul Bunch. He has been scoring in bunches. 6 points already for him. Six of the 10 points for the Hornets coming from Bunch. All even at 10 here. Here's Bauer. Out of Thomas. Now Wilson. Swinging it over. Witt. He loses possession. Witt trying to stay with it. Played well by Caleb Wright. Look at the height difference on Witt and Wright. And as we talked about yesterday, Witt might be the best defender on this team. And offensive foul. There he goes. Moving his feet. Using his feet on defense, he's able to draw the offensive foul. So Thomas takes a seat. Isaiah Matthews will come on. And Matthews, who did not play yesterday, is suiting up today. Regular starter now coming off the bench, working his way back from injury, and offensive foul. Let's see who this goes against. Maybe the returning Matthews. That'll be on Fred Wilson. That is his first. Rattler coaches here are going to have to be careful and have to be very aware of shuffling their lineup. They don't want the fouls to start piling up as they did yesterday. That, of course, came very close to costing St. Mary's. There's Witt. Almost got that steal. So quick in those passing lanes. His size allows him to be so elusive. That foul will go against Witt, though. That's his first foul of the game. St. Mary's has put Emporia State in the bonus, so that will send Caleb Wright to the line. Caleb Wright, their leading scorer. 15.1 points per game. First free throw for him on a 1-1 is no good. They're still even at 10. Alexander skies for the rebound. Here is Bauer. Dribbling, working left. Now Wilson gaining possession. The two senior captains, Bauer and Wilson, playing a little pitch and catch. Bauer high off the glass. Matthews trying to come up with the rebound. Takes a bit of a tumble. He's right back up, sprinting down court. Rebound comes out to Emporia State. Here is Wright on the left side. Another foul here. Let's see who it's against. It's going to go against Alexander. That'll be his first. And once again, Rattlers already in the bonus. 18 fouls committed already, and not 8 minutes in. So a little cause for concern, especially going back to last night's game. You had four Rattlers foul out, and a bevy of them with three fouls, four fouls. So you want to be careful there. First free throw is good. And Paul Bunch gives Emporia State a one-point lead. Here's the back end of the 1-1. Second free throw is good. The big man, 6'11", senior from Chicago, Illinois. Able to calmly knock on those two free throws. It's rare to see a big guy have such ease, such a nice stroke at the free throw line. Bunch there, able to get those. Here's Bauer. Had a look at the three, pulls it back. Going to try to run the offense. A lot of clock remaining for the Rattlers. Here's Witt, Al Wilson, Matthews at the elbow. Almost got stripped. He is fouled. And that will reset the shot clock here for St. Mary's. We invite your Rattler fans to check out our social media pages, facebook.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. We're also on Twitter, at St. Mary's Rattlers, on Instagram, at St. Mary's Rattlers. Rattler Network archived programming, youtube.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. And, of course, for everything on St. Mary's Rattler Athletics, score, stats, news, game write-ups, schedules, ticket information, event info, rattlerathletics.com. A two-point lead for Emporia State. That one is off the hands of Alexander. It'll stay with the Hornets under their basket. Approaching 12 minutes here in the half. Here's Bunch. And again, another foul. And that's going against Alexander. And you can hear the crowd not happy at all with that call. As Alexander has picked up his second. And, well, one broadcaster up here thinks that was a bit of a phantom call. I'm not sure what infraction Alexander committed. Nonetheless, it will send Bunch to the line. He already has eight. First free throw is good, and Bunch, 3-for-3 in his last three free throw attempts. Efi AK checking in. AK had a very nice game yesterday. One of the bright spots for AK this season. He had four fouls going into that overtime, and he was able to keep himself from being fouled out. As that free throw, no good. And AK there with a rebound. AK also had a huge block in that overtime and played very smart defense, not making contact, just making contact with the ball. AK rewarded here with some early playing time. Rattlers face a three-point deficit, and again, another foul. This one will go against Emporia State's on 21, Javon Taylor. Rattler fans at home, keep count of the fouls. 57 in yesterday's game. Looks like it's hitting that way. Stay with us, Rattler fans. You're watching the grand finale of the Thanksgiving Classic right here on the Rattler Network.
Kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. 11:51 remaining in the first half. What a Thanksgiving weekend. Hopefully you've had a terrific weekend with friends and family celebrating. And from all of us here at the Rattler Network to you and yours, happy Thanksgiving, happy holidays, happy Black Friday. Hope it was a prosperous one. Hope no one got trampled on their... Oh, no one got trampled in their quest for savings. Here the Rattlers trying to save this game before it gets out of hand. AK not able to get the put in from Witt. I believe a technical foul has been called. Technical foul will be on the Rattler bench. It looks to be on Coach Zelsnack. He has been heavily protesting these calls. It will put a Hornet at the line. Caleb Wright will take these free throws in. Well, Rattler fans, make sure to tweet us at St. Mary's Rattlers. Rattler Network colleagues at underscore Joe Rodriguez underscore and at BMAG23 already tweeting conversation about the ref's whistles already being heard loudly as one free throw is good off of that technical trip to the line. So two technical free throws and the ball is retained by Emporia State. Rattlers here have to maintain their composure and they look to stay in this ball game. Good ball movement by Emporia State. They move it well and they find that open man. There's Brown for three, no good. Rebound by Witt. And another interesting stat of last night's game, Witt led the team in rebounding. Yes, the 5'9 guard had 8 rebounds in that overtime game to go along with 21 points to lead all scorers. Witt doing work. The foul is called and it will give the Rattlers their possession right back under the basket. 11:20 remaining here. A 4-point deficit for St. Mary's. Here's AK posting underneath. No good. Ball goes right off of Matthews. A 4-point lead for Emporia State here. Rattlers are doing a good job trying to hang on defensively, making Emporia State take some tough shots. That one just too easy. A little bit of a breakdown on defense for St. Mary's gives Emporia State an easy one down low. 16-10 the score. Here's Witt driving all the way. He is fouled. So Witt will head to the line. Witt, as we've talked about, it seems to be the story with him. A diminutive player. He's a junior guard, 5'9", from Birmingham, Alabama. Joe Rodriguez's column, Cup of Joe, doing a great job in profiling Marvin Witt. And I mean, he knows it himself. The player that comes to mind when you think of a guy like Witt, you think of Allen Iverson, and he himself says that he admires Allen Iverson and understands that a player that even his size can thrive in basketball, a tall man's game. And Witt has definitely proved that here early on in his Rattler career. Down low, that pass too high there for Bunch. Excuse me, too high for Bedejo. So that one will go out of bounds. It will be Rattler basketball. A 4-point deficit now for St. Mary's after the Witt free throws. Witt, a terrific free throw shooter. He can hit him down the stretch. Here's Matthews posting. Gets that to go. Matthews with the bucket. He's right back. Matthews back. Did not play in yesterday's game. Oh, there's the rejection. Wilson doing a great job there. Hey, Bodejo wanted a foul, but that was all ball. And Wilson saying that was all me. Good defensive play there from the Rattlers. A 2-point deficit now as we are at exactly 10 minutes remaining in the first half at the exact midway point of this opening half of the contest. And a blocking foul that goes against Witt, and that's a big foul. That's his second. So Witt will take a seat. It will prompt Bryce Smith to check in. And once again, both teams now in the bonus. It will put Emporia State at the line. 21, Javon Taylor. First shot of his free throw attempts. I believe Emporia State is in the double bonus, so they'll be getting two shots from here on out. First shot is good for Taylor. Second shot, no good. Rebound to Bryce Smith, and now Bauer. Now some full court pressure being shown to Bauer. Now Wilson able to catch this pass, and he in it throws it away. It is stolen. Here's Emporia State. Right, driving. Had no control of that one. Just puts one up, and it'll be a loose ball foul. It goes against Emporia State. Possession for St. Mary's. It's on Paul Bunch. And Bunch picks up his second. That's a big foul, too. 9 points for him already in this half, and he'll be taking a seat, and more than likely he'll be watching the rest of this half from the bench as Matthews will head over to the free throw line. Matthews, a native of Texas City, Texas, has his family in attendance. Before the game, his little cousin ran up to me, introduced himself. Very polite young man. His name is DJ, and he said, "Hey, I like what you do on the court." I'm like, "Thanks, I like what your cousin does on the court." I told him, and we both shared a giggle there. As Matthews, not able to get his free throw to go. Still a 3-point game, Rattlers lead it. Down low is right. Tough move, tough bucket, no, doesn't go. Offensive board for Emporia State, count that one, and the foul. That's a bad break for St. Mary's. And they secured the rebound. Instead, it's an opportunity for Emporia State. Made this a 6-point deficit for St. Mary's. And the Rattlers here have to find some answers offensively. They've fallen very stagnant here. Only 14. A high-scoring bunch. That one off the front iron. Here come the Rattlers trying to break this press. Bauer and Smith in the backcourt. Nice pass to AK. Had Matthews open. AK didn't recognize it. A lot of time left on the shot clock. Bauer trying to get a spot on the court, trying to stay open. It is deflected out of bounds. It'll stay with St. Mary's. Good bounce there for the Rattlers. Bauer with the inbound. Matthews back to Bauer. Now left side, Bryce Smith. Matthews trying to post. Offensive foul. Matthews getting a little too physical down low, and he'll be tacked with his first foul of the evening. And once again, if you're keeping track at home, that's 18 fouls already. And we are going to the replay booth. Not sure what they're wanting to investigate. We'll take a timeout with them. Stay with us, Rattler fans. A 5-point deficit for St. Mary's as we conclude our coverage of the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic.
Clean kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Rattler fans, Emporia State leading St. Mary's Rattlers, 14-19. David Tovar bringing you the call all by my lonesome on this Thanksgiving Classic weekend inside Bill Greehey Arena. I miss my partners, Joe, Brian. I know you fellas are watching. Howdy. Emporia State trying to move the ball around. Here's Brown driving against Matthews. Spin, shoots. Luckily, there was no whistle called there. And a shot clock violation. I'm not sure if that ball hit the rim. It looked to me like it did hit the rim. Nonetheless, the shot clock violation is enforced, and it'll be Rattler basketball nonetheless. Approaching now 8 minutes to go here in the opening half. Bauer's going to line it up for three. Offensive foul. That's going against Isaiah Matthews, and Matthews is beside himself, just pacing. You can see it on his face and in the walk, upset, a little frustrated. These whistles can tend to do that to players, especially when, well, I don't think any player ever thinks they commit a foul. Here are the Rattlers playing some zone. This three is launched, no good. Rebound out to Emporia State. It's Brown trying to corral it. He does. Swung over the three. It's good for the Hornets. That three coming from 21, Javon Taylor. And Taylor with four now on the afternoon. Here's Bauer driving. He gets his shot rejected. It's sent back. Here is Wright driving. Nice pass. Count it and the foul. Emporia State beginning to roll here. 24-14. And the media timeout could not have come at a better time. 7:21. The Rattlers will look to regroup. They trail by double digits, 24-14. Stay with us, St. Mary's. Emporia State in the grand finale of the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic.
Kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. 7:21 remaining in the first half. And if you haven't yet, it's time to get in the game and check out the all-new RattlerGear.com, St. Mary's Athletics' one-stop online store for everything blue and gold. Buy now for a free gift of a St. Mary's Rattlers 17-ounce mug with a purchase of $50 at RattlerGear.com. Also, check out our customized replica basketball jerseys, now 10% off. So, holiday season, of course, if you didn't make out like a bandit, on Black Friday, check out RattlerGear.com. And apparently RattlerGear will have a Cyber Monday special going on. So be on the lookout for that. So many cool things at RattlerGear.com. That free throw is no good. So the Rattlers trail by 10. And for now, don't see their lead for the Hornets increase. A 10-second violation. Bauer not able to get that over the timeline. Great defense being played here by Emporia State. The Rattlers really in dire need of trying to get their offense rolling. Emporia State comes in with a 6-2 record. They won their opening game of the Thanksgiving Classic over Southeastern Oklahoma State, 81-66. They're 1-1 away from home. This is a road game indeed for Emporia State. That layup is good. Good ball movement there. And that is good for McWisdom Badejo. Again, the press. Thomas. It's cleared by Matthews over the timeline. Now Matthews, a bit of a pickle, going to pick up the dribble. Back to Matthews. Now Smith. Bryce Smith has become a solid guard in the rotation. Rattlers right now without Marvin Witt. Two fouls with 4 points. Of course, Witzel instrumental in that overtime game last night. 21 points, 8 rebounds at 5'9", leading the team in rebounding. Here's the three by Smith. That's good. Bryce Smith able to tickle the twine on that three-pointer from range. Smith there getting himself going. Has three. And has cut the Rattlers' lead down to 9. AK defending. Now Smith and Matthews. Ball being moved around. Right to Brown. Brown on the left side working against Thomas. Here's Jordan. Taylor and now Wright. Wright for three. That is no good. And the tip-in by Gavin Brown. You got to box out. The Rowers did not do that there. This lead is back up to 11 for Emporia State. And again, Emporia State relentless with this press. Bauer to Matthews. Ball finally cleared past the timeline. Rattlers already been caught behind the half-court line with a 10-second violation. Two players take a tumble. No whistle there, surprisingly. Here's Bauer. Bryce Smith down low. Now Thomas spins, turns, passing up nowhere. Those are empty seats. An empty possession there for the St. Mary's Rattlers. And an 11-point deficit for St. Mary's. J.J. Bolton looking to check back in. Bolton in for Efi AK. Bolton here with two fouls. A couple Rattlers on the floor with two fouls. Bolton, Thomas, and Matthews. All with two fouls for the Rattlers on the floor. Witt with two fouls and Alexander with two fouls. They're both on the bench. Foul is called here. It's an offensive foul. So Rattler basketball here. 4:49 remaining in the first half. An 11-point lead here. Beautiful HD graphics on your computer screens. 17-28 the score. Here's Bauer. Calmly bringing it up the court. No press shown on this defensive possession. Now Bauer going to line it up for three. Off the front iron. Matthews engulfs this one. Shot put up, no good. Here's Smith. Try to get the loose ball. It is stripped. Now Brown to Taylor, and now Wright will bring this up the court, and he'll try to set something up offensively for Emporia State. Bolton defending. Wright gets around. Nice little pass. It ends up right back in the hands of Wright. Now Brown splits the double team and gets a floater to go. Offensive foul. Good job there. I believe that's Ryan Thomas doing a good job, able to eat that and draw the foul and swing possession right back over. Basket will count. That's odd. The basket will count. Not sure how that's interpreted there, but I believe the, I don't know, maybe the ball was released before the contact was made. Nonetheless, 13-point lead, but Ryan Thomas at the line. First free throw is good. So Thomas will get to see the back end of the 1-1. 12-point deficit here for St. Mary's. Thomas looking to cut into that one. And he does. Free throw is good. Micah Swank bringing it up court. Screen beat set here by Bodejo. Over to Peterson and now Taylor. Right. Fakes the pass. Takes it all the way, and that bounces in. Wright has been playing very well for Emporia State. Leads the team in scoring, about 15 a game. Already has 5. Foul on the floor. It's against number 20, Josh Peterson. And that will take us to our final media timeout of the half. Rattler fans, if you haven't yet, be sure to join Rattler Nation today and support all your favorite teams that make up Rattler Athletics. All Rattler Nation members get discounts at rattlergear.com and invites to Rattler Nation socials. Those are great. And donors giving at the $150 level get free admission to all St. Mary's regular season home events. For more information on that, check out RattlerAthletics.com. Rattler fans, how much do you love your Rattlers? They trail by 13 right now. Stay with us. More upcoming Thanksgiving Classic continues on the Rattler Network. Welcome back, Rattler fans. 3:36 remaining in the first half. David Tovar here with you on Thanksgiving weekend. And personally, I couldn't choose any other way to close out my Thanksgiving weekend than to be here with you, Rattler fans. And, of course, Rattler basketball. Okay, maybe one way. Some more Thanksgiving. It'll be my not seconds, not thirds, not fourths. More like 10, 11s. It's been a terrific weekend. And that free throw is good. So Matthews goes one of two at the line. A 12-point lead now for Emporia State. Rattlers trying to fight in this. They attempt their version of a press. And Emporia State does a good job breaking that. Over the timeline they go. Here's Swank controlling, working against Bolton. Swank drops it off to Wright. Bauer defending. Right. Oh, he's rejected by Matthews. Good job staying with that play. Now Smith takes it up, and he has fouled Smith. Trying to do a little bit of a Marvin Witt impression there, taking it all the way amongst the trees. So that goes against Swank. That'll be his first, and Bryce Smith now at the line. His first free throw attempts of the evening. Here's Smith, first free throw is good. And Bryce Smith, you talk to the coaching staff and they rave about how much he's really progressed here in his Rattler career. One of the guys who they've entrusted who can run and orchestrate the offense when the starters need a bit of a breather. Second free throw is good for Smith. And he's really come a long way, and you've seen it here in this season. Timeout on the floor, 10-point lead. Rattlers trying to claw back in this one. Thanksgiving Classic grand finale right here on the Rattler Network. Welcome back, Rattler fans. A good one here inside Bill Greehey Arena. Rattlers and Hornets to close out the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic. What a sport weekend we've already had. We've had some good college football games, including the one that just finished maybe an hour ago. What a classic in the Iron Bowl. Us here at the Rattler Network working the game. We weren't able to get ourselves near a TV to watch the live finale, but of course, with the power of social media, as a foul is called on Emporia State, it's going to nullify the basket. But yeah, with the power of social media on Twitter, Facebook, it's this blew up social media, that finish. Definitely envious of the people that were there live. Here's Thomas driving. That's good. Just the beauty of sports and, frankly, the beauty of social media. And speaking of social media, follow us on Twitter at St. Mary's Rattlers. Follow our Instagram account at St. Mary's Rattlers. Facebook.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. And, of course, for the official site, RattlerAthletics.com. Rattlers get it down to 8 here Ball swung around. Good passing by Emporia State. They're trying to find the open shot. They do here. That three way off the mark. No good. Bolton able to chase it down. And now here come the Rattlers here. They have a little bit of steam. Bolton going to slow it down. Looking down low. And Bolton bailed out there as that was a bit of a risky pass. The foul will go against Emporia. It'll go on Pedersen. That is his second. Efi Ake about to check in for St. Mary's. Isaiah Matthews back at the line. 3 points for Matthews on the evening. First free throw is good. Matthews, of course, who didn't play yesterday, back in action tonight. Bolton out, and in comes Ake. You see Christian Bauer giving instructions to the bigs. 7 point deficit now for St. Mary's. Let's see what Matthews does here on the second attempt. It's good. Lead is now down to six, 32-26. Just under the 2 minute warning here in the first half. Caleb Bright down low. Bodejo over the swing. Between the legs, trying to get open. Offensive foul. And now the whistle seems to be going against Emporia State. We'll take that here inside Bill Greer Arena. 89 seconds remaining here in this first half, and a timeout is taken. Rattler fans, stay with us. More upcoming. Thanksgiving Classic.
If you drive buzzed, it could cost you around $10,000. You'll face major legal fees, major fines, and steep insurance penalties. You could lose everything. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Back, Rattler fans, 1:23 here as the first half about to come to a close, and Emporia State, that ball taking a bounce out of bounds. And so it will be Rattler basketball, 6 point deficit for the Rattlers. They trailed by as many as 12. They've cut that deficit in half. Bauer, Thomas, Matthews, Smith, and AK. Five on the floor. Here's AK, flips one up, and he is fouled on his way up in the act of shooting, so he will go to the line for two. Efi Ake, of course, one of those intriguing Rattlers. Originally hailing from Nigeria, a Division I transfer from Louisiana Monroe. First free throw is good, and that's the thing about St. Mary's, is a lot of, it's a melting pot. A lot of cultures. Got a Marvin Witt, of course, from Alabama. Marvin Binney from the T-Dot, Toronto. Bauer from Arizona, beautiful province of Arizona. And there's AK, knocks down the second one. My first province reference all season. 1 minute remaining. Rattlers get this back down to four. Good job of the Rattlers playing good defense and forcing Emporia State to commit turnovers, offensive fouls, and all the like here to get back in this one. Wright with the fake, loses possession. Bauer all alone, lays it up, and good. Christian Bauer able to finish that off. And now it is a 2 point lead. And the Rattler fans and the Rattler bench excited here. Rattlers need one more good defensive stand here. And it looks like Emporia State will hold to the conclusion of this half. Rattlers got to play good defense, and they do there. They force a turnover there, an errant pass there by Jay to Matt. With 11 seconds, Marvin Witt will check back in. He'll come in for AK. And Witt, of course, instant offense. That's the guy you want potentially with the final possession in any half. Here for the Rattlers to even this back up, maybe even take the lead with a three-pointer. Let's see what happens here. Emporia State looking like they won't play a press. They're going to let Bauer get all the way up front. Now under 5 seconds. Here's Bauer. Takes a screen from Thomas. Got to put it up quick. Matthews turns, shoots. Just too strong. And that will do it. The Rattlers trail by 12. They claw back. They trail by 2 going into the half. Rattler fans, this is shaping up to be a good finale. Stay with us. More upcoming. The finale to the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic exclusively on the Rattler Network. Welcome back, Rattler fans. A two-point lead for Emporia State sets the stage for this second half, what could be another thriller. David Tovar bringing to the call, maybe joined by a special guest later on in the half, but nonetheless, the Rattlers want to be joined by another win here in the Thanksgiving Classic 2013. A new five on the floor for St. Mary's, and the one that started the game. Bauer is joined in the backcourt by Witt, and in the front court, it's Bolton, Matthews, and Alexander. Emporia State with Wright, Brown, Moore, Bunch, and Swing. Good defense being played here by the Rattlers on this opening possession. Wright, jumper, tough one, no good. Offensive board to Brown, and Witt able to pickpocket this one. He gets the steal, now up court. Right side of Bauer, he took a long look, he drives. The floater just bounces out. Offensive board by Matthews, and that's good. And the Rattlers picking up right where they left off. High octane, good defense leading to good offense. It was a story in the women's game earlier this afternoon. As a foul is called here, and that will go against Alexander, and quickly he picks up his third. Alexander, who picked up two quick fouls in that first half, is now in big foul trouble here as he has his third, and quickly Ryan Thomas will supplant, will come in and sub in for Alexander. The referees there wiping away the sweat on the floor. Thomas now joins Bauer, Witt, Bolton, and Matthews in Rattler gold. Swank will take it from underneath the basket. 19 minutes even here remaining in regulation. And you remember, Rattler fans, 24 hours ago, Rattlers were in overtime, as that is an easy layup there for Wright. Just weaves through traffic. Rattlers winning that their opener in the Thanksgiving Classic 81-78 against Central Missouri, once again in overtime. Here's Bauer. Floats one up. No good. Shot is short. Moore with the rebound. Now driving. Dumps it off to Wright. Wright. Nice pass to Bunch. And Bunch with his first basket of the second half. Bunch scored in bunches in that first half. He had nine. Add two more to his total for 11 on the evening. Bolton, that pass. Risky over to Thomas. Now to Bauer. Left side working. Here's Witt for three. Launches. Too strong. No good. Bolton with the offensive board. And he's going to bring it out. Try to reset. Bolton. Over to Thomas in a three-second violation. Goes against St. Mary's, and I believe a technical foul has been called on Fred Wilson, who is on the bench. These officials not having it. This is a second technical called on the Rattlers bench. The first one going against the head coach, Jim Zelsnack, and this one against Fred Wilson. I guess too much chatter for the referee's liking. First free throw is good for Swank. And these referees really have allowed their whistles to blow. If you're keeping count at home, 28 total fouls called in that first half. 57 were called in yesterday's ball game. That was 45 minutes of action. That game went into overtime. 57 fouls called there. Right now we're at 29, so we'll be keeping that stat for you as this game goes on. Four Rattlers here with two fouls apiece. Wilson, Matthews, Bolton, and Witt. So the two technical free throws, but it will be Rattler basketball on their baseline. Inbound from Bauer. Now Thomas. Back to Bauer. Now Matthews down low. Post looking. Matthews again. Dribbles. Tough shot. He is fouled. And you have to love the aggressive play there from Matthews. Brian Thomas also has two fouls. Alexander with three for Emporia. You got two guys with two fouls. Number 11, Terrence Moore. Number one, Gavin Brown. And then one player with three fouls, Paul Bunch, the center who's been terrific for the Hornets tonight. Matthews at the line. Matthews going to get tended to on the bench. A little bit of stoppage in play here. Now Matthews returns. So Matthews here at the line looking to cut the lead. Rattlers tied it up at 32, and from there, Emporia has gone on a 6-0 run. First free throw is good. Matthews has been solid at the line this afternoon. I should say now this evening. Second free throw is good. 38-34. Emporia, here is Swank. Over to Brown. Defended well by Matthews all the way out at the three-point line. Moore drops it off to Brown for three. That shot too strong. Bolton comes up with a rebound. And he'll bring it up court. Now Bauer with possession, trying to get something going offensively. Witt back in. Here's Thomas. Had some room. Dribbles, drives all the way. That shot way too short. No good. Rebound out to Emporia. Rowers really helped their case to end that first half. They played some terrific defense. It really led to a lot of offense. Rowers here need to channel back into that defensive mode that they had going into the break in order to keep this one close. With Emporia State, the drive, the spin by Swank, that one teetering. And it'll be a loose ball foul. It goes against Swank. And a fourth foul picked up by Paul Bunch. That is terrible news for the Hornets as he leads them in scoring with 11. He leads them in fouls as well now. So he will be seeing a large chunk of this second half on the bench. Let's see if the Rattlers can get something going here now. Matthews not able to finish that off, but again, draws the foul, gets himself to the line. His aggressive play has voted very well for St. Mary's here, and they'll need more of that to remain in this one. So Matthews at the line. Rattler fans, we invite you to check out our brand new rattlergear.com. Buy a lot of gifts for family and friends. What better way to stuff your stockings than rattlergear.com? And a Cyber Monday special on rattlergear.com. Make sure to log on and check it out. Some good deals upcoming all over the place on Cyber Monday. First free throw is good. Second one off the mark. And the Rattlers almost get their hands on that offensive rebound. Emporia State scrambles. And now they maintain possession. Here's Moore. Across the timeline now over to Swink. Met by Witt. Brown drops it off to Wright. Good ball passing. That shot no good. There is Witt, another rebound. Skye for the rebound. He's a terrific rebounder at 5'9". He had 8 rebounds in yesterday's game, pacing the Rattlers and rebounding in yesterday's overtime affair. Down low to Thomas. Spin, shoots. That hook shot, no good. Just off the mark there for Thomas as we are under 16 minutes to go here in the second half. Nice move by Wright. And he is fouled there. And just the minimalist of contact that goes against Thomas. And so when we come back, it'll be right at the line. Rattler fans, stay right where you are. Thanksgiving Classic concludes here inside Bill Greehy Arena. Rattlers Hornets right here on the Rattler Network.
kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. A 3-point lead for Emporia State. David Tovar bringing the call high above Bill Greehy Arena as the Rattlers square off with the Hornets in the grand finale of the Thanksgiving Classic. And now we are joined, a special guest, a special Thanksgiving treat for myself and for you, as that shot is good by Witt. The one and only Mr. Chad Peters. Chad, welcome aboard.
Exciting game so far, huh?
Indeed. You've gotten a glimpse from every angle at Bill Greehy Arena.
Really like the mental toughness that this Rattlers team is showing. You know, this is a squad that advanced to the regional tournament last year, the Sweet 16, for the first time as an NCAA member. But a new-look squad. So few guys left, and you can't just assume that that same type of finish will be there for this year's team. These guys are showing they have that within them, too.
Rattlers kind of reloading. And this team just as talented as the last, and well, the history books will tell us if that talent is matched. Of course, the goal for this team is to not only win the Heartland Conference title again, they have won not one, not two, they're going on three. And of course, they look to go back to the regional tournament. As an offensive foul here, it's on Emporia State. They picked up a lot of offensive fouls here, so the Rattlers here with this possession can possibly take the lead.
Had a good chat with Coach Z last night after the game. Talked about why you schedule a tournament like this early in the season. He said it's to simulate tournament play. You know, you go to the Heartland tournament, you go to the regional tournament, and what do you have? You have hopefully a big emotional win in that opening round where you got to get right back out there and play the next day. And he said that's what they try to do and simulate here in this kind of setting. And there, Marvin Witt will be shooting a free throw here. Was that a technical?
I believe so. A technical foul now in Emporia State. So two technicals on St. Mary's, one on Emporia State. Witt at the line. First free throw is good. And, well, you witnessed it firsthand, Rattler fans. Witt clutch. 14 of 14 from the free throw line yesterday, including 6 of 6 down the stretch. It was terrific.
And it's 14 for 14, the most on record in St. Mary's history for most free throws made without a miss. So a great showing, and he keeps it going right there. He's now in double figures for the night, joining Isaiah Matthews with 10 points. But, you know, Coach Z, going back to that thought, talked about wanting to – so he's so happy they got the big emotional win last night, but he said the guys now get to see what it's all about in terms of turning it off, turning it back on the next day. They can't celebrate that win for very long. You have to get refocused or else you're going to come down here and get your butts kicked. They're refocused.
And, indeed, you talk about an emotional win. Overtime thriller at home, 81-78, coming off of probably a lot of turkey. And they're able to muster up a terrific effort. Here's Wilson for three from the corner. That shot, no good. This place would have exploded had that fallen. Rebound comes out to Emporia. Left side, driving. Good defensive stand. You got a rebound. And that is too easy there for Emporia.
We saw a big comeback in game one of today's bookend day of the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic. It was Southeastern Oklahoma State winning by about 20 early on. Central Missouri came back to win that game. Rattlers trying to duplicate that tonight after trailing by double figures there in the first half.
Even more symmetry in the comeback section. Lady Rattlers also trailed big against St. Thomas in the first game of a triple header here inside Bill Greehy Arena. They came back and they won that one. A sloppy game, but one of those games that really brought the team together. And a sloppy effort, admittedly, by Coach Martins after the game. But got to be proud of those young ladies for coming back and not packing up shop, as that one is good there. Monroe able to get the put back there from Witt. And again, this is kind of shaping out to be like that first game, St. Thomas and St. Mary's. Both teams trading the lead.
I think Joe Monroe showing right there what his strength is. To me, his strength for him offensively, his hustle around the basket, energy, and just relentlessness, his ability to get that tip in off the rebound. I think he brings a lot of energy for the St. Mary's offense.
Bonaggio is blocked, but a foul, of course, is called on this play. It goes against Matthews. That'll be his third. 28 total fouls called in the first half. At this juncture, we are at 10.
And he and Matthews, both redshirt juniors, so they're, you know, four-year guys in the program, will be entering their fifth year next year. You've seen the growth of them quite literally, updating the programs and just kind of looking through that over the years. They started out at 185, both listed at 225 now. And Matthews, especially if you follow his Instagram or Facebook accounts, I mean, it showed you the offseason, the amount of work he put in the gym and the payoff. And he's out-muscling teams now with the performances he's putting in.
Yeah, I got to chit-chat with Isaiah's mother before one of the games. She came up to me, lovely woman, introduced herself, big fan.
And Beverly.
Yes. And I said, I'm a big fan of your son's work. And I asked him how he gets so buff, how he gets so ripped. Pass on the secret. And she said he went on a string diet as soon as he got home back to Texas City. So
really,
I'll have to subscribe to that after the holidays, of course. That free throw is good. 2 for 2 at the line. And again, the lead is traded. Emporia State now up one.
Timing definitely everything when it comes to dieting.
I wouldn't know. Witt on the left side. Down low to Monroe. A foul there. And well, Rattle fans, brace yourself. We're going to get a stoppage maybe on every possession here. Because hopefully they swing the way of St. Mary's. So now Monroe will go to the line. Monroe, of course, from San Antonio Stevens. And you talk about him, a redshirt junior. Probably the most athletic player on this team, is so versatile and is really finding a role on this team as more than just that athletic player. Free throw is good. He can rebound. He can defend solidly.
And it's all part of that quest. Hate to bring up the name again, but to replace Kevin Kotzer. And you used to have a 2010 guy coming from, you know, that kind of performance coming from one player. Now you're having to get it collectively from a group of guys. And I think this group of guys are showing that they can do it. Justin Alexander, Monroe, Matthews, Thomas, Ifeake. I mean, the list goes on. They all bring a little something different, and they're all being productive for this team.
And it's showing up in a win column and more. That's a tough one.
High off the glass there.
Yeah, Rattlers want no more of that. As that is good. Again, a two-point lead now for Emporia State. Rattlers had it even at 42. Here's Bauer now. Drops it off to Wilson. Down low to Monroe. Showing off the post moves. Loses possession. Stays with it. Almost got that to go. And the rebound comes off to Alexander. Monroe up high. The alley-oop from Fred Wilson. That's a heads-up play by Wilson. And a good finish there by Monroe.
And David, you mentioned the personal foul total. We're up to 38 tonight. We had 63 called last night between the teams, so we're not quite there yet. We'll see if we reach it.
That's the magic number, 63. Moore again, driving. Oh, here's a good way to get to that number, and Moore. Walt is in the lane.
And Monroe trying to draw the charge. Interesting to note, though, looking up to the scoreboard, yeah, that's Monroe's third foul. He picked up two quick tonight. I mean, real quick in this game. And here we are, almost the midway point of the second half. So I think he's done a good job to kind of withhold himself from getting more fouls, because he could have quickly gotten himself out of this game.
Yeah, another guy who picked up two quick ones. Alexander, he's sitting at three. Hopefully stays at three. But with this, the way that this game is being officiated, I'm going to hold my breath.
Yeah, last night, again, can't reiterate it enough, four Rattlers fouled out. Ifeake played all of overtime with four fouls, so he was one away from fouling out himself. Rattlers down to one guy on the bench, and that was Jared Anthony. I'm not kidding. Six guys were available to play at that point of the game. And it was quite a recipe for success.
Emporia State, a very solid team. They're 6-2 on the year, 1-1 away from home. They were successful in their first game here at the Thanksgiving Classic. They beat Southeastern Oklahoma State by 15. Down low to Alexander, and he is fouled. Rattler fans, I'm not kidding. Brace yourself for a stoppage every possession, potentially, as we are looking for our magic number. I thought it was 57, and indeed 63. So Alexander now at the line, and he'll be attempting to tie this one back up.
And free throw shooting becomes so critical in a game like this, doesn't it? It's the reason you work on all that for all those hours during the offseason.
And yeah, you want to simulate tournament play and big-time free throws. I mean, who would think a free throw is so big with about 12 and a half remaining? But that's indeed what those free throws were. Evens this game back, right back up at 46. Now here's Wright driving, right side, flips it up and good. What a terrific drive to the basket. He gets that to go. Once again, Hornets up by two. There's Bauer left side looking for AK and does. Top of the key, AK drives, called for a travel. Indecisiveness, the mating call of turnovers. Five on the floor for the Rattlers. Bauer, Witt, Wilson, AK, and Alexander. Here's Wright. Gets that to go. Tough jump shot. Again, Wright scoring from all angles. He has 11. He leads the Hornets in scoring, about 15 a game this season. Down low, Alexander. That's too easy. That's a gimme. And we'll take that one all night long.
And on that previous possession for Emporia State, they're really doing some work near the basket. We've seen three straight possessions by them, just really clever ways to score the basket.
Here's Witt, able to pick up the rebound and taking it in transition. Bauer open for three. That shot no good. Alexander trying to come up with the rebound, but he is fouled. Loose ball foul goes against Emporia State. And that will prompt us to our second media timeout of the half. Rattler fans, hold on tight. This is going to get good. A two-point lead for Emporia State as the St. Mary's Rattlers try to close out their Thanksgiving Classic with a victory right here on the Rattler Network.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed, it could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. 11:19 remaining in regulation. David Tovar, Chad Peters, what a treat it is for us to bring you this grand finale of the Thanksgiving Classic, a.k.a. a foul fest. What a way to bring us a little homecoming for ourselves, Chad. We talked about it on the first broadcast, started from the bottom, now we're here in the immortal words of Aubrey Graham, better known as Drake the Rapper. And from our humble beginnings on the Snake Pit to an audio-only broadcast to live, beautiful HD as the second free throw by Alexander. Excuse me, the first free throw is no good, and the Rattlers regain possession.
Going down to the floor for the rebound, paying it off with the basket. Something Coach Z preaches and really harps on, the hustle. You see it right there by Justin Alexander.
And Alexander missing a free throw, the first of a 1-1. Rattlers able to corral the rebound, and Alexander able to redeem himself. Twice over, gets two instead of one. And we'll take that deal every time. Similar to Black Friday deals going on all over the country. Here's Swank. Uses the screen. Now trapped. Oh, dangerous pass. Bodejo. That shot no good. And Witt again, skying for the rebound.
We talked about this last night. He's such a good rebounder for his position. Four rebounds now tonight. Had a team high eight last night. A guy that can really fill up the stat sheet in numerous ways.
Oh, Bauer not able to finish that layup. Alexander comes up with a rebound. That one, going to go off Alexander, but Referee on the baseline making the call, and now they're going to confer. Overturned. Thankfully, no red flag was thrown on the court. Referees get that one right, and it'll be a Rattler ball with a fresh shot clock at 34.
You know, Jason Kidd had that soda spilling incident the other night. That'd be a good prop to have a basketball coach pull. Just pull out the red flag at a time just to kind of see if, you know.
Why not? And that's a throw! And Marvin Witt finding his groove here in the second half. A big three. He has 13 to lead all scorers. And Emporia State wants to chit-chat about it. We'll stay and chit-chat a little bit here with you, Rattler fans.
You know, David, Robert Johnson and I talked about this throughout last night's broadcast, and it's twofold. This team needs a leader. I think you're seeing him step up in Marvin Witt. And I think, secondly, he's going to quickly become a fan favorite if he's not already. After that win last night, I mean, the Rowdy Rattlers were bear-hugging him there in the cheering section, and he's doing it once again tonight. A big clutch performance by Marvin Witt.
Say that old cliche. It's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog. So Witt really showing off, and of course our colleague Joe Rodriguez and his terrific column Cup of Joe. I mean, we all the name comes to mind, and of course Witt recognizes his size and reminiscent of Allen Iverson. He was one of the NBA greats, and for being listed at 6 foot, he was really maybe 5'10 on a good day, and he played like a 7 footer. My favorite, LeBron James naming him his favorite player to watch. That's the greatness of an Allen Iverson, and the greatness of a Marvin Witt, kind of taking the role of maybe the little general. Of course, Spur fans remember Avery Johnson, his jersey hanging in the rafters of the AT&T Center. And I mean, if it's a big man's game, but diminutive players do have their roles, and especially when you're dynamic like a Marvin Witt.
And what I think it does is it presents great lineup possibilities for Coach Z. When Marvin Binney returns from injury, what do you do? Who starts? You got the point guard, the veteran leader in Christian Bauer. You have Witt and Binney, the two Marvins, both slashing athletic guys. How do you want to manipulate and massage that lineup? Who's the spark off the bench? All of those things, a great situation for Coach Z.
Indeed, and that's always fun when you have too much of a good thing. Under 10 minutes remaining here in the second half. Rattlers playing some inspired defense. Moore for three, trying to bring the momentum back to Emporia. And Alexander recognizes he bit on that fake a little too hard. Makes contact with Brown, and that'll be four on Alexander. So the Rattler bench again will have to step up big. Alexander starting the second half, did not start the game. He's been very good, making some timely rebounds, 8 points for him. And we'll have Joe Monroe check back in momentarily.
Yeah, with Alexander, the coach is telling us this week, he's a guy really who deserves to be starting. He should be starting, but they love his consistency, his steady play, and they've liked bringing him off the bench here this season because of all the new faces. They know that maybe some irregularity in the type of play, the way the game starts, well, they can insert Alexander 4 or 5 minutes into the game and get some steady play thereafter.
Well, being a member of the Church of Manu Ginobili, I've always enjoyed having great players come off the bench, and it's very rare to get a great player who's willing to come off the bench, but you see it here at St. Mary's. You got a Witt, you got an Alexander. Here's the press that St. Mary's struggled with mightily in that first half. They break it here. He's AK, not able to get a handle on this one. He loses possession. Bauer trying to impede progress, and he does, and is called for a foul. What a fast play.
Being blinded momentarily there by one of the watches of one of the assistant coaches on the Emporia State staff. Every time I look, I was like, who has the flash photography? But it was just the reflection. Sorry, so I have
big watch. First free throw is good. And I think I spy the same watch you do. Maybe our camera's picking it up as well.
Like, not, you're not supposed to look directly into the sun. Do not look directly into the watch.
Maybe that free throw miss caused by the reflection of that watch. One would only hope. All even again at 53. Bauer almost turns it over. Witt right there. Right place, right time. Who else would it be? What would Witt do? Bauer, now Wilson, right side. Nice fake. Dumps it off. Good pass again. That's another great pass from Wilson. Wilson finding Monroe on the alley-oop and finds AK. AK with the rejection.
Ooh, kill him. Hashtag MNMN. Wow.
You know, AK is a guy new to the system. And you can tell probably struggling to pick up the offensive sets and the system a little bit so far. But, boy, can he contribute in numerous ways. And you see that he had a big block last night. Already a big block here with 9 minutes remaining. Man, that got people off their feet here at Bill Greehey Arena.
Indeed. You know, seeing him for the first time at Media Day, he's one of those guys, the word you think of, legit. He just looks so legit. Maybe carved out of stone right there.
The nice beard, the cool hair, too. Just the whole package really yeah, looks right on the basketball court.
Indeed. And so showing off the athletic prowess on that huge block and a foul, of course. This will be on the Rattlers on the floor. It'll be on Fred Wilson. And boy, Wilson has really come on here in the second half. His passing, one of the senior leaders on this team. He'll take a seat as Bolton will come in. But Wilson, two good dimes that have gotten the Rattlers some easy buckets and has really gotten the crowd going. But at the line, it will be Gavin Brown.
And you see the towel being used to mop the court. One of the, I guess, the unfortunate parts of a Thanksgiving tournament where you don't have your student workers, we don't have the cool floor mops that we've been seeing out here.
Indeed. We have those handy, but maybe won't make their return until 2014, excuse me. Brown, free throws. First one is good. And so Emporia State now within one. Substitution, Swank out, in comes Taylor.
A special thank you to Chris Thompson tonight, assistant athletic director for facilities, also the game operations event manager, coordinator as well, and he behind the camera for this broadcast. So special thank you to Chris.
Yeah, brand new to our Rattler Athletics family. Always great to add more people. Makes for a great family reunion. Here's Bauer. Down low, AK. Not able to get that. Gets his own rebound. AK again. He's rejected. And so, looks like karma has come back around on AK. Good rejection there by Bunch.
Yeah, here. Good defense by Bunch there, one on two. He's able to hold down the fort defensively.
Indeed, at 6'11". That's no easy feat as Witt trying to get behind Bunch, but Bunch, of course, able to get that easy basket. Bauer running through the cones. Now Witt all the way again, going right at Bunch. And he gets that to go right there. Witt calling his own basket there. And he did that in the first half, Chad. Witt just going right at Bunch. 5'9 against 6'11. And again, 5'9 coming out victorious.
And what good ball handling by Christian Bauer, getting the ball up court, slicing between two defenders there to set that whole thing up.
Treating those defenders like traffic cones. Here's more offensive foul. And if that is against Bunch, that's it for him. And that is it for Paul Bunch. And that
huge
could swing the game completely away from Emporia State. Don't have his number yet.
11
points.
But now, a huge presence down low.
Oh, indeed. And that could potentially change the complexion of this game.
Yeah, if you're keeping score from home, right down 7 minutes and 55 seconds, tied score 57 all. Definitely a turning point in this ball game potentially.
Indeed, 18 fouls called here in this second half, 28 called in the previous half, for a grand total of, I'm not a math major, grand total of 46, I believe, on the evening. 63 is our magic number from yesterday, but of course that also in extra overtime. But wow, what a significant turn here on the blow of a whistle.
Yeah, I believe we're at 45 right now.
45.
22 for us, 23 for them.
Even. So home court advantage not really doing much here for the referees. Well, Rattlers fans, we hope we've had a terrific Thanksgiving weekend. We appreciate you spending some of it with us. So much to be thankful for here at Rattler Athletics, the park at St. Mary's, me personally, all my colleagues, so many great ones we've gotten this year. Chad Peters, I'm sure you're thankful for a lot as well.
Yeah, without a doubt. First Thanksgiving with an 11-month-old son, Austin. So that was pretty cool.
Got to see him today. Precious.
Yeah, enjoyed some St. Mary's basketball.
Terrific. Can't wait to sign him up for the, again, not a math major. What would you say, 2030 season maybe?
Yeah, haven't done that math yet either myself.
Well, it's never too early, right? Matthews. Oh. That is an unforced error and a mental mistake if there ever was one in a tied ball game. 57 all.
Did he go over and back on that one?
I think he caught the ball going over and back. It happened simultaneously. I think he did.
I don't know if I've ever really seen an example like that to know the rule, because it almost seemed like he caught it like his left foot was on the left side of the court. His right foot was in midair. Hard to kind of tell, but
Emporia State gets that bucket off a turnover. A two-point lead now for the Hornets. Witt gets that over to Bolton. You play a little tighter in these situations. You know, some guys are having some open shots. Bolton and Al Monroe, and that one is going to be nullified as apparently the ball is still on the cylinder, and Monroe with a huge putback. That would be good in the FIBA games. Not in the NCAAs, and of course.
Did you think that one was in the cylinder still?
You know, I think it was. I don't think it was fully out. I think it was still kind of hanging. You know, it has to be that direct line, kind of like the three there from Moore, no good. Kind of like the intentional grounding. There's that imaginary line, right? So it's that imaginary line that goes up from the rim, and, well, referee's had a better vantage point than me. Here's Witt for three. No big deal. We'll take that three.
I was just about to say, how long until Witt just kind of puts the ball in his hands and takes a shot, and there it is.
18 points. He had 21 last game.
25.
25, excuse me.
That's career high.
He's right back on track to match and or eclipse his career high.
6 of 12, 2 for 4 from downtown. Also 4 for 4 from the free throw line. So 18 for 18 in the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic.
Ball out of bounds. It'll stay with Emporia State. Chad, you began the campaign for Witt to start. You might have to make room on that bandwagon. He has been terrific.
And that's why I brought up the question tonight. What do you do with the lineup moving forward? Because Benny is spectacular.
Yes.
Witt has been sensational. Someone's going to have to sit. But I think the good thing is you can work that to where your second unit all of a sudden now has a superstar.
And, of course, all second units need that guy to command. And Witt can do it. Benny, who can also fill up.
Both those guys are juniors, too. That's the kind of the cool part. So you got the senior in Bauer kind of anchoring that guard position. The two juniors in the Marvins.
Starving for some Marvins, indeed. And, well, we're starving for Marvin Binney to get back. But right now, we are feasting with Witt. Here's Wright. Oh, wow. Lucky no call there for the Rattlers. They get away with one here. Here's Witt trying to keep it alive. And again, Witt. Putting on a show. It helps to be that size, I assume. You can do so much. You're so athletic and versatile with that size. And right there, Witt saving that possession for St. Mary's.
The number 20 jersey from RattlerGear.com might have to be bought at some point here. Of course, you can't have the name Witt on the back of those if you're buying that, since he's a current player. But boy, oh boy, that number 20 is looking pretty good right now.
Wow, he has been terrific. And of course, San Antonio fans used to dynamic number 20s.
That'd be a good kind of way to rectify the situation. Get the 20 St. Mary's jersey. Just stick Ginobili on the back.
Yeah,
for a name.
It might as well. It solves all problems. Here's Bauer, 1-point lead for St. Mary's. Playing a little less tight here, as that pass from Bolton is deflected, looking for Witt. It goes out of bounds. The Rattlers will keep it. 16 remaining on the Rattlers shot clock. And boy, oh boy, what a way to open up the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic. And potentially, it looks to be quite a finish here at the St. Mary's Classic.
And Emporia State, just like Central Missouri last night, a very, very good team. So this type of competitive battle, a good showing by St. Mary's that they're in this kind of class with these teams.
Bauer drops it off to Bolton. Puts up a tough one. That shot no good. And some rumbling and tumbling down in the paint. Monroe goes down. And so does number 5, Daniel Shaw, goes down. Shaw in relief of Paul Bunch. Bunch, who had 11 points, and he was scoring in bunches. Picked up fouls in bunches as well. Fouled out with about 9 minutes remaining in this game. And so Shaw now in, and he will head to the line looking for his first points of the game.
Both teams doing pretty well at the free throw line. Jinx. Ha. I kid, but no. Emporia State 20 for 29 now, about 70%. St. Mary's almost 80%, one of the better games we've seen from them as a team. 19 for 24 from the stripe.
Rattler still hanging on to that one-point lead. Now Witt, ball in his hands. You're excited. Here's Matthews, now Bauer. Over to Bolton. Licking, trying to make the right pass, and does. And again, Rattler's bailed out as their offense kind of stalled a little bit. A foul called, and that will put Matthews back in the line.
Just one final thought on Witt as we talk about that possession there. What I like about his game is you don't see him force a lot of shots. When he had the ball in the corner there, he could have very easily kind of tried to do an ISO move and just jack up a shot. That's not what Coach Z wants, and I think that's one reason why you're going to see him really thrive and flourish in this offense, is he plays a pretty unselfish game.
Matthews has been solid at the line tonight. Continues that. First free throw knocked in calmly. That's good. And
you know, if you didn't know about Isaiah, a heck of a videographer, too. I don't know what he's better at, basketball, videography, music. I mean, you name it, he's good at it.
He's a renaissance man.
Yeah, he actually produced, directed, shot our pregame intro videos that we show here in the arena.
Both for the men and women.
Yep.
And he knocked down two big free throws. But, yeah, Matthews is multi-talented, as a lot of our Rattler athletes are. A lot of great stories across the Rattler athletics. Over to Moore now. Emporia State looking to even this back up. Moore slicing, dicing, gets that to go. 62-61 now, and crunch time upcoming.
And the Rowdy Rattlers starting the Let's Go Rattler chants.
Down low, and offensive foul. It goes against Matthews. Seems to wrap his arm around as he tried to make that spin move. It'll be his fourth foul on the night. And so once again, the Rattlers now have two players inching toward being fouled out. It's Matthews and Monroe.
And on the bench, Alexander also with four, and Ryan Thomas with three.
So making three players now. One away from fouling out. Again, the bench getting a little tighter. Moore not able to finish, and that is heartbreaking. But Asia able to bring that in. The tip-in is good. 63-62. Bauer, pick for Matthews. Bauer again gets that to go. Nice layup there by Christian Bauer.
Bauer, another guy who does a nice job of picking and choosing at the right time when to take it himself.
Yeah, Bauer also a very potent scorer when needed. He can drive, and he can has a good floater, and he can lay it up very well. And right there, he shows that off. So not only can he orchestrate the offense, he can also create the offense for himself. Here's Moore. He's been creating a lot of offense for Emporia State, and that rebound corralled by Monroe. Almost thrown away. Bauer, again, slicing right through the defense. Going to bring it back. Now he's trapped. And a timeout is called by Coach Selznack.
Well, we said all night this is shaping up to be a fantastic finish, and it's exactly that, a one-point game. Of course, you go back to Bunch fouling out, the 7:55 mark. Tied ball game there. Rattlers only going plus one since. Going to be an interesting finish with all the Rattler posts who are now in foul trouble themselves.
Indeed, four of the Rattler big men in trouble. Matthews, Monroe, and Alexander Thomas right behind them with three. Then you have some good outputs here from St. Mary's. Witt, of course, leading the way with 18. Matthews with 12. Alexander with 8. Monroe with 7. So it's been a balanced effort for St. Mary's, and they're looking at another thriller here. 24 hours removed from an overtime win against Central Missouri, 81-78. The final inside Bill Corey Arena last night.
Think our guys are going to be tired when this tournament's over?
Ooh, man. Looks like they're going to sleep in all the way till Monday.
I think I will as well.
Yeah, good thing there's no Cowboy game tomorrow. That frees up my whole Sunday. Well, Rattler fans, once again, we hope you had a terrific Thanksgiving weekend. We appreciate you taking some time out of it with us here at the Rattler Network. A special hello to our colleagues at home enjoying time with their families. Brian McGlouillon in Houston. Joe Rodriguez, who tweeted me saying, I'm not from Dallas. Fine, Arlington. Wherever Cowboys, wherever AT&T Stadium is, Joe. Happy Thanksgiving to you. Howdy. Of course, over at the Four Letters. Another shout out to Mr. Peters.
Robin Johnson down on the table. Aileen Zelznak handling the Twitter account tonight.
So many people to make Rattler Network go and bring you this production. We're so very proud of it. Beautiful high definition. All right, Rattler fans, hope you grabbed a bag of chips. The final act commences. 3:18 now remaining. The Rattlers lead by one. Bauer, Witt, Alexander, Matthews, and Bolton on the floor in Rattler gold. Here's Witt. Possession knocked away from him. It'll stay with St. Mary's. All right, one final intermission before that final act. Stay with us, Rattler fans. 3:07 remaining. If you haven't yet, grab that bag of chips. Grab a soda. Get some more turkey. It's going to be a good finish right here on the Rattler Network. Fans, welcome back. Hope you're armed and loaded with a lot of good food to enjoy the last 3:07 of this one. 64-63, St. Mary's Emporia State from Bill Gray Arena. David Tovar, Chad Peters bringing you the call. Witt, Matthews, Alexander, Bolton, and Bauer. Five on the floor in St. Mary's gold. Witt for two. That shot no good. Offensive board almost corralled by Alexander. Instead picked up by Emporia State.
If you have any Thanksgiving leftovers left, now would be a good time to heat those up and enjoy the show.
As the once great T.O. said, get your popcorn ready. Offensive foul, that's against Emporia State. Badejo picks up that one. That is his fourth, so Emporia State, their second best big man in this game, is also one foul away from joining Bunch and becoming the bench bunch of fouled out players.
Battle of attrition at this point. Both teams.
Here's Bolton. Matthews slips, so Bolton retreats. Over to Bauer. Gonna launch a three, wide open. That shot too strong, Alexander comes up with it. Tries to flip it up, no good, and another big clutch offensive rebound. And see, clutch comes in a lot of ways. That's a clutch rebound there, a clutch pass, a clutch steal. Of course, the clutch baskets.
And the Rattlers are so good at rebounding. This is something the coaching staff has told us all season about, too, that they've really liked about their squad, that some of the guys you might not expect big rebounding numbers from, J.J. Bolton, the little undersized Marvin Witt, they're really, really good rebounders for their position. and you see it come up. Yeah, you might expect Alexander to pull down the seven or eight boards, but other guys are able to bring in those numbers as well.
Yeah, when the men's Rattlers played St. Thomas on the 19th, they out-rebounded them by, I think, 19. I mean, it was just an impressive number.
And it's funny how the men's and women's teams can mirror each other sometimes, because the women's team the exact same way. Morgan Pullins had 17 boards today. We've seen Kiara Etheridge with 18 and 20 this season. I mean, it is ridiculous what they do on the glass.
And as our colleague Joe Rodriguez says, rebounding wins titles. And so the better rebounding teams, of course, are more successful. And good to know both Rattlers, and Witt almost loses possession. And wow, a big break there. Impatience by Terrence Moore. He fouls Witt, and so Witt at the line. And wow, talk about being bailed out. Witt almost lost that one. He bobbled, and it almost went out of bounds on Witt. He's able to hold on to it, and Moore trying to force too much there. We'll send Witt to the line. First free throw, and Witt again calmly knocks that one down.
They say sometimes it's better to be lucky than good, but when you're lucky and good,
it's a dangerous combination. Witt sets up for the second. Gets that to go. Witt. You're almost afraid of
20 for 20. Matches his jersey number here at the line this tournament.
I was about to say, you're almost afraid to even mention anything. Kind of like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter or a perfect game bid.
Yeah, you know Joe saying no, no from his living room right now.
He's got his hat on in the rally cap, and that three is good by Swink. 66, all Rattler fans, we're telling you, brace yourself, we are under the two-minute warning. Inside Bill Greehy Arena. Witt with the ball in his hands. Let's see if there's any more magic left. Witt, nice dish!
Wow!
And the foul that will send Matthews to the line. What a pass by Witt! Oh my goodness!
That was just fantastic. And you see, again, the versatility of this team, the unselfishness. And for a team playing, what is it, the seventh game of the season? For the team playing so early in the year, the unselfishness and the camaraderie you're seeing these guys build. No one is worried about taking the winning shot themselves.
Matthews not able to finish that three-point play, but gives the Rattlers a two-point lead here. And you're absolutely right. This team, if this doesn't bring you together, well, I don't know what can, partner. We're approaching 1 minute remaining here. 68-66. Wright swings it over to Brown. Now to Moore, defended by Witt. Down low, double team now. Wright trying to work the hook shot, no good. Good rebound there by Matthews, able to secure possession. Now Bauer has it. We are under a minute now as the Rattlers try to hold on here. 2-point lead.
Yeah, big possession here for St. Mary's. If they can get one more basket, it will really put them in the driver's seat down the stretch.
Large and in charge. As you mentioned, with one more bucket, here's Witt. Killer crossover, reminiscent of one Iverson. Here's Witt. All the way, gonna flip it up. Off the glass, no good. Rebound of Emporia. Shot clock matches the game clock for Emporia. Swing. Over to Wright, now to Moore. Brown, good passing here by Emporia, but they gotta make a decision quick. A lapse on defense. Right all the way. And wow, Emporia capitalizing off a defensive switch gone wrong for the St. Mary's Rattlers. 68 all as Bolton is hurt.
Yeah, Bolton was struck in either the eye or something, and that's why you saw him run away from the play. It created a huge lane for the Emporia State player. And now Bolton on the bench getting treatment from the trainer, Jamie Jolliffe, holding a gauze over his eye.
It's going to be an interesting development going forward in this ball game. 68-68, all 16.1 remaining.
David, it's so oddly reminiscent of last night's game. I'll try to paint this picture. I believe it was in overtime. A huge sequence where Ife Ake blocks a shot. The ball's battling around. He's not able to get the rebound. The ball ends up going over. Well, to recap, when he blocks the shot, he injures a player for Central Missouri. Gets him in the face. No call, though, is called. So that player then is hanging around the wing, facing the bench, so not looking toward the action, standing covering his face. A loose ball then, you know, 3, 4, 5 seconds later comes his way, goes right over him. If he is turning and looking, he would get the rebound and keep the game alive. Rattler's, though, able to get the ball, and then he inadvertently swipes and fouls St. Mary's. So St. Mary's goes to the line, so he's hurt, not able to get the rebound because he's hurt, and then fouls, and St. Mary's able to win the game. So just kind of an odd similarity there, same end of the court and everything here tonight, as J.J. Bolton completely taken out of the play as he was hit in the face.
He is now at the trainer's table getting looked at. Wow.
I think the first thing that comes to mind nowadays when you see something like that, you wonder, you know, did their contact pop out? You see that all the time, someone kind of, you know, looking at their eye like that. But I think he legitimately got poked. He's still holding the gauze over, I believe, the eye. It's either the eye or he might actually have a cut up on his forehead. It's hard to tell.
I think more of a cut if he's still holding the over his eye. And wow, Rattler fans, if you weren't breathless enough. 68-68. If this doesn't wake you up out of your food coma, I'm not sure what can.
Yeah, a crazy development. The good thing for St. Mary's, though, is that that sequence happens still with 16 seconds left. Timeout on the floor. They can run their offense and do what they want, and if they do things right, they're taking the final shot of regulation. So that is the good out of that sequence. Of course, the best scenario would have been a defensive stop. You win the game. But still, St. Mary's can be in the driver's seat with a tied game. 68 all, 16.1 seconds remaining, and could we be seeing another overtime battle here for St. Mary's in this Thanksgiving Classic?
What a way to open the Classic. What a way to finish the Classic if this goes into overtime. And regardless, what a great game we've seen inside Bill Gore here. You know, what a weekend of basketball we've been treated to. Good games all around to open up last night, and then the early game of the triple header, the women's game between St. Mary's and St. Thomas, and now this one. Wow, we are on the edge of our seats. Rattler fans, for all the coverage, check out rattlerathletics.com. Tweets coming to us, text messages bombarding our phone.
And it is worth noting, David, that the officials are looking at the monitor. So I don't know exactly what all the specifications are of what they could be looking at, if they could be trying to assess a foul retroactively or if they're looking at the time. You might know better than I.
Yeah, maybe the time they're trying to figure out the schematics of this one, trying to get everything.
You got to love it. St. Mary's president, Tom Mingler, a face in the crowd tonight, sitting there right behind the replay monitor next to Brother Al. So a good crowd. He's here for the women's game with his wife, Mona. Both are back for the nightcap. So President Mingler spending his Thanksgiving out here with you, the Rattler fans, and with us, Rattler Network.
Indeed. He's got to be enjoying this one. What a great game to be at. Might not have the allure of the Iron Bowl, but oh my God, one of these teams are definitely made out of steel if they can hold on. 68 all, 16.1 remaining.
Yeah, you mentioned the Iron Bowl. Advice for St. Mary's, do not attempt a 57-yard field goal here with 12 seconds remaining.
Indeed, keep a safety in your end zone. Here is Bauer, 5 seconds. They're gonna hold for the last shot. Who's it going to? Of course, Witt flips it up.
Oh!
Marvin Witt for the win. And the Rattlers win this one, 70-68. Marvin Magic.
Wow. Still technically 0.2 seconds left. I don't know what they can do in that situation.
I am hoping that the 0.2 is a formality. Marvin Witt, of course, who else were you going to put the ball in their hands? It goes to Witt, drives in on the left side, comes back out to the elbow, flips up an improbable shot. The shortest player on the court, bar none. And he gets that one to go. Marvin Magic Witt, coin it now.
And the officials will review this one to see how much time they should keep on the clock, if it's point more, point two, or a little more. We'll see what they end up putting on there. Marvin Witt, now his stat line this evening, 22 points, 7 of 15 shooting, 2 for 4 from beyond the arc, 6 for 6, still has not missed his tournament from the foul stripe. And again, look at the other numbers he has, 6 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 steals. The guy, as you say, is magic for the St. Mary's Rattlers.
My, oh my.
So how do you follow up a 25-point game where you establish yourself, assert yourself as the leader? You do what he's done tonight.
You hit the potential game winner. We're 0.2 for making that official. My, oh, my.
And Kayleen Zelznak was going to write the story tonight for us for RattlerAthletics.com. She might have to fight Robin Johnson and myself for this one. Holy cow.
Wow. So who's the interview?
Yeah, we try to divvy it up, kind of get different guys, different nights, but my gosh, Thanksgiving, it's like Romo in the month of November.
Yes.
Marvin Witt. Thanksgiving is his holiday.
He has been magical in the last two games, and I don't know what turkey he ate, but I'll have some of that. Hopefully he's got some leftovers. Marvin Witt has been terrific.
It's funny, I mean, Coach challenged him yesterday before the game. They had a lengthy conversation, challenged him to step up. We need you. Marvin Benny's out. We need you to be a leader. And he listened. The officials do award one extra tenth of a second, as you see on your scoreboard, 0.3 remaining. Still don't know that that's enough to get a shot clock off. And the score updated now to reflect St. Mary's up 70-68. We here in the booth, you get so excited on a call like that, you forget to punch the button to make it official.
Indeed, and a timeout taken here by Emporia State.
So the biggest thing, does it go without saying, for St. Mary's, just do not foul.
Yeah.
I mean, is that the biggest thing in a moment like this?
Indeed. If they inbound, I mean, whatever the case being, if you inbound from, if they have to go the full length of the court, you kind of just stand everybody at the, you know, everybody toward the basket and make sure there's no easy basket. Of course, a three can still win it for Emporia, but with 0.3, it's highly unlikely. I believe the rule came after the infamous 0.4,
yeah,
where the only thing that's allowed is a catch and shoot, and it has to be, I mean, not even a blink of an eye. So I truly think, and well, objectively, or I should say unobjectively, hope that the 0.3 is a formality and the Rattlers can escape 70-68. Well, here we go. They will have to go the full length of the court. Emporia now to inbound. Not sure what kind of play you draw for this. All the way. And that will do it. No Christian Leitner miracle here for Emporia State. It's the Marvin Magic Witt Show as the St. Mary's Rattlers thrill the crowd here inside Bill Greer Arena. Thrilling Thanksgiving classic by St. Mary's, headlined by the magic of Marvin Witt.
I don't know how they did it tonight, David. I didn't know how they did it last night with all their foul trouble. And again, you walk away not knowing how they did it. And boy, oh boy, is that a good situation for these Rattlers. Another home win, them and the women's teams. Neither one has lost here at home this season. And Emporia State, you see them walking off the field, the court, pretty dejected right now. The Rattlers, as energetic as they can be, as they get two hard-earned wins over tough opponents here in the Thanksgiving Classic.
Rattlers will be off until December 7th, and boy, that is a well-deserved break. What a tournament, what a Thanksgiving Classic, what a show all these Rattlers put on. But of course, as I mentioned, headlined by Marvin with his terrific play, his clutch play. I mean, boy, you talk about the clutch gene. I think this young man was born with it, bigger than he is.
Yeah, the height is pretty deceiving when it comes to Marvin Witt, because he might be 5'9", but he plays so much bigger than that. And it's going to be an interesting storyline for the Rattlers moving forward, as the smallest guy on the court might just be the best.
Well, Rattler fans, that will about do it for us. Happy Thanksgiving indeed to all you Rattler fans. Wow. Any more closing thoughts? I mean, I think we've said everything. We're all talked out here.
Yeah, I think so many things come to mind. I think you've seen a team come together, and I think it couldn't have come at a better time. A new squad, new faces. How do they get along? Are guys mad about minutes? Do guys like each other? I think wins like this can make a lot of that go away. I think you're going to see a camaraderie pretty unique for a team that's being built, playing so new. That's so new. And then I think you've seen the leader emerge. You've seen perhaps the showcase performer emerge in Marvin Witt. Other great performances come to mind as well. Bauer, some timely baskets. Isaiah Matthews really held down the post position. I think Justin Alexander's an underrated guy, someone who doesn't always put up the huge numbers, but he you walk away from games really being impressed by what he does and when he does it, just to name a few. And the good news, Marvin Binney will be back soon, hopefully, so it should even get better.
Well, I concur with all your thoughts and sentiments, partner. I don't think I have much else to add other than, again, Rattler fans, what a thriller. Your Rattlers victorious 70-68 to close out their Thanksgiving Classic inside Belk Arena against Emporia State. For everyone here at the Rattler Network, a happy Thanksgiving to you and yours. A happy Thanksgiving to our colleagues, Brian, Joe. Happy Thanksgiving to you, partner.
Happy Thanksgiving, my friend.
Thanksgiving treat for me to have you back in the booth.
It's been fun. And, Joe and Brian might have to wrestle me at this point to get the broadcasting feedback. I'm good luck, you know? What can I say?
Yeah, wait for those tweets to come in. All right, Rattler fans. Well, that will wrap up our coverage of the 2013 St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic from Belk Arena. David Tovar, Chad Peters, we thank you for joining us. This has been a presentation of Rattler Athletics on the Rattler Network.